Does your shampoo leave your scalp itchy and your hair dry and frizzy? Introducing Emrick's Essentials Natural Herbal Shampoo. Made with organic oils for an exhilarating fragrance. Enjoy all natural and chemical-free shampoo for a healthier you. Gentle enough for color-treated hair and sensitive scalps. Only pure, organic, antiseptic herbs that have demonstrated antimicrobial activity are used. Go natural. Go organic. No parabens or sulfates. Nothing to weigh you down. Get cleaner, healthier hair with Emrick's Essentials Tea Tree Shampoo. This natural tea tree shampoo is made in the USA and certified made with organic ingredients, unlike other hair care products that claim to be organic but are not. For a silkier, smoother, shinier, clean look, try Emrick's Essentials Herbal Shampoo. Feel more natural. Feel more confident. Feel the difference. Restore your alluring characteristics to a younger landscape. Rejuvenate. Reinvigorate. Revitalize your hair. Enhance your hair care experience today with Emrick's Essentials Natural Herbal Tea Tree Shampoo.
You'll find Emrick's Essentials at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
Receiving this transmission, you are the resistance.
Hollywood!
Hollywood!
Babylon!
Babylon!
Hollywood!
Hollywood!
Is that Elvis? All right, let's get serious. Darren McBreen, he doesn't usually do this. He's a great guy, one of our better editors and researchers. They're all excellent. But he put together this ultimate Maxine Waters cringe fest video / audio. It's up on InfoWars.com if you're a radio listener. You want to see it? It is Mad Maxine, the Maxine Waters movie. Then we're going to come back and take your phone calls, 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. Your call's coming up after this, but here it is. A lot of time in the making. It's powerful. Mad Maxine.
Waters has been charged with ethics violations for asking regulators to help a bank in which her husband had a financial interest. She denies breaking any house rules.
What people have seen on television in recent days is outlandish behavior by the Tea Party operation in Washington, D.C. And I think think that speaks volumes about what's causing problems in Washington.
What exactly outlandish behavior? Specifically, what do you mean by that?
The shouting. The Republicans were out there having a great time. They were laughing. They were waving the American flag. They were egging them on. And I thought that was outrageous behavior. I really did.
Guess what this liberal will be all about? This liberal will be all about socializing. Basically, taking over and the government running all of your companies.
Chapter 2, My Russian Narrative.
This is a bunch of scumbags. That's what they are.
Those are very strong
words.
They're
all organized around making money.
Bing, bing, bong, bong, bing, bing, bing.
You have an investigation going on where the president is implicated.
Just to be clear, there has been no actual evidence yet.
No, it has not been.
Okay.
No, it has not. Can't people see what's going on? Why do you think they hacked into our election? They hacked into the election because they have to make sure that Donald Trump got elected.
Maxine Waters is not only a traitor to our nation, but she's not right in the head. In fact, the only people who are crazier than Maxine Waters are the people who support her.
Chapter 4, My Lies, My Hypocrisies, My Millennials.
At this stage of my life, I get a little confused sometimes, and it sounds like I'm batshit crazy. But there's a method to my madness, because this struggle, it ain't no joke. And my millennials, they stay woke.
Maxine Waters, the Democratic congresswoman calling for President Trump's impeachment, getting a standing ovation before presenting the award for best fight against the system.
You are very vocal in supporting an investigation that could lead to President Trump being impeached.
The millennials have adopted me because they really do believe I speak truth to power. And I discovered one thing. Just tell the truth. I have not called for impeachment. Impeach 45.
The president is a liar. His actions are contemptible. And I'm going to fight every day until he's impeached.
I have not called for the impeachment yet. I say it over and over again, impeachment, impeachment, impeachment. And I will fight every day until he is impeached.
Man, this woman lies.
Impeach 45.
This isn't edited. She says it back and forth.
Impeach 45.
Should we wait to call for impeachment until we have the answers to that question?
Well, some of the questions? I have not called for impeachment.
You said I'm going to fight every day until he's impeached. That's what you tweeted.
You know people don't like to hear the word impeachment, but we know you like saying it.
He lies every day. He's in bed with Putin and the Russians about oil. And everybody around him are allies with the Kremlin.
Yes, we want the oil. We want the Russian resources, Dumbo.
This is extraordinary. This woman is delusional.
That's what we do, Maxine. We're capitalists.
He said it.
I go back to...
What grown man talks like that?
I go back to President Clinton.
I don't care about Clinton. Well, of course. I care about this because I'm going to work every day until I get him impeached.
I really do believe that much of what you saw coming out of Trump's mouth was a play from Putin's playbook. I think that when you saw him absolutely calling Hillary crooked...
Crooked Hillary!
Lock her up, all of that was developed. I think that was developed strategically. With people from the Kremlin, with Putin.
You obviously have been very critical of James Comey in the past. You said that he had no credibility. I assume that you support the president's decision then to fire his FBI director.
No, I do not necessarily. The FBI director has no credibility.
But if you said that FBI Director James Comey had no credibility, wouldn't you support the fact that the president, then candidate
oh, no.
Trump, now President
no, no,
Trump
no,
made
no.
the decision
no.
to get rid of him?
No, not necessarily.
If Hillary Clinton had won the White House, would you have recommended that she fire FBI Director James Comey?
Well, let me tell you something. If she had won the White House, I believe that given what he did to her and what he tried to do, she should have fired him. Yes, the FBI director has no credibility. We want a diplomatic solution. We do not want war in North Korea. In Aleppo. And the fact that he is wrapping his arms around Putin while Putin is continuing to advance into Korea, North Korea, Korea at all.
Those goddamn North Koreans.
They are some sneaky bastards.
Stop it. That's all we want. It's too much pain.
Stay woke.
My millennials, stay woke.
We'll be back with your calls. The videos on InfoWars. Thanks to your support, InfoWars has been able to expand its operations against the globalists at this critical time. And it's absolutely essential that we expand in the face of the enemy because, as history shows, political movements only expand or contract. And that's why the globalists are hitting us with everything they've got. Censorship, demonization, attacks, misrepresentations. They're not just trying to shut down InfoWars. They're trying to fire Sean Hannity. They're trying to cull talk radio. They're trying to silence true independent nationalistic media. And InfoWars is at the very heart of that resistance. We all see the dumbed-down trendies that appear to be soulless and how they're obsessed with consumerism and criticizing capitalism as they walk around in their expensive Nike tennis shoes and have their slave-made iPhones. So I personally am disgusted by empty consumerism. But the globalists want to get rid of free markets because there is such a thing as positive consumerism historically, where people can use the power they have of the purse to actually support building free and independent economies. So you're not just getting amazing products when you go to InfoWarsStore.com. You're also supporting a broadcast that is the very front lines of the resistance against the globalist. Now, we offer a lot of specials at InfoWarsStore.com on nutraceuticals, on high-quality water filtration systems, you name it. But these particular specials that we're offering for Memorial Day and out into next week are undoubtedly some of the best we've ever offered. On the subject of colloidal silver, and of course with Knockout and Brain Force, these are the best deals ever. 65% off high-quality colloidal silver. Sign up for auto ship, an additional 10% off. That is 75% off. That's at least 15 points lower than we've ever gone. To introduce folks to high-quality colloidal silver, perhaps never gotten it before. We've got Brain Force, 47% off. Secret 12, 43%. Knockout, Sleep Aid, 50%. Survival Shield, back in stock, 40% off. Super Male, sold out for months, 30% off. And you sign up for auto ship, cancel anytime, you get an additional 10% off on that as well at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. In closing, we've already come this far together, and we've seen the devastating effects truth has against the global crime syndicate, but the enemy's striking back. So again, for myself, the entire InfoWars crew, I want to salute and thank all of you. No matter what color you are or where you came from, if the love of liberty and justice beats in your heart, if the love of standing up against tyrants flows through your veins, we are all brothers and sisters together in this epic experiment that is life. So again, thank you all for your support. Visit InfoWarsStore.com today to get some of the best deals ever offered on incredible nutraceuticals, supplements, and so much more.
Men, give your body the support it needs with InfoWars Life Prostaguard. It's time to start assisting the body in regulating proper prostate balance. InfoWars Life has set out to bring you formulations that are not only the highest quality out there, but formulas that you can use on a daily basis to give your body the natural herbs and extracts that our experts recommend. The Prostaguard formula does just that, with its mixture of plant-based nutrients and antioxidants that help give your body total support. It's a hand-selected blend of saw palmetto, lycopene, plant sterols, zinc, vitamin D3, selenium, and copper. Prostaguard is something that the men on the InfoWars crew take every day. And from our research, it's something that men should really be adding to their daily regimen in order to keep their body going at optimal levels. Now's the time to start naturally supporting your body. Get Prostaguard on your side today, exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide. It's Alex Jones.
I know you deceive me, now here's a surprise.
You know, there's all these news articles out that I claim Megyn Kelly's coming to interview me next week, like I've arrived or something. I mean, I'm not bragging here, but I almost am not doing the interview. Because I don't even want to put up with it or deal with mainstream media. I've been on Nightline, I've been on Fox, I've been on everything. I don't really get any response off these shows. And I turn down most of the interviews. I turn them down every day. But I know she has a big magazine show. And she's got a big show coming out on NBC. She just interviewed Putin. She told me that 2 weeks ago, but said, please don't tell anybody. Well, now you see the interview with Putin's airing this Sunday. And it's Putin, Alex Jones, and then Trump. And I'd be dumb if I didn't do some of these interviews. I know it's edited. I know they're going to attack me. I understand that. They told me they're not going to. I'm not stupid. But when she gets here, I'm going to play her the clip of where, because she goes, I don't remember that on Fox, where they play a clip where I'm saying Hillary killed all these kids in Syria, and they played it and said I was talking about the pizza place. And I'm going to sit there with her. I'm going to say, look at this. See what you did right here? Here's the original clip. It doesn't even matter. The point is that the media makes a joke and says, Jones blushed. He's in love with Megyn Kelly. Megyn Kelly didn't have enough meat on her bones, okay? I haven't been enamored with people in Hollywood for 18 years. I mean, Hollywood early on got me in films. I was out in Hollywood quite a bit, and I was never enamored with it, but I really don't like it now. And I've been at parties, would you name it, Brad Pitt, you name it. I mean, small parties, okay? I've been there. I like Clint Eastwood. I like Kurt Russell. I'm a big fan of those guys. Clint Eastwood's a living legend and a patriot. But it's because their politics, I like them. And they're good in their movies, but I don't worship that. And the reason I raise this is I would have loved to interview somebody like Alexander Solzhenitsyn, a real patriot for humanity. That I get butterflies about. Or Trump, because he's such a trailblazer. That is my rock stars. Or a Billy Corgan, who's got great music. Gotta play more of his bumper piece. I love Smashing Pumpkins and his other stuff he does on his own. But I like Billy because he's so smart. We talk on the phone, you know, quite a bit and text each other. But it's not because he's a famous. It's because he's an interesting person. And I just think it's so important that we reject celebrity culture. It's so important that we just say no to whatever they're force-feeding us. Because whatever they're force-feeding us, the Ariana Grandes or the Taylor Swifts, is just a load of crap. And what they add on to it is meant to snare our daughters particularly. I'm going to go to your calls. When we come back from break, John and Matt and John and Trent and Carlos, I'll go right to you. 800-259-9231 is the toll-free number, but I don't want to go to you here with a minute or two we have left and then not give you enough time. A long segment, 18-minute segment's coming up, so we're going to go to break, come back and talk to you. But briefly, on some other news, too, I haven't gotten to. Maybe I shouldn't do the interview with Megyn Kelly. But then I realized when I saw these articles, they'll say I made it up. I have to. That's the level I've now gotten to where the media all said I had my kids taken away and that didn't happen. And the media was there in the courtroom when it didn't happen. They all left and didn't report it. Do you have any idea how controlled the Austin American Statesman is? And I don't even care. Because I know they're a bunch of liars. But I mean, wow. Wow. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. I sat there and I watched that ruling Tuesday. And I watched the media. It looked like they had all been punched in the stomach and they all left. And I knew there wouldn't be a word. They even had coordinated like a... What's the name of that show? Extra or Inside Edition or whatever. That was all coordinated weeks before to air that afternoon. Thinking it would get piggybacked in some ruling against me. I mean, they talk about concerted with the media. I mean, and then to watch them have everything they thought was going to happen not happen, it's just wild. And to have Hillary attacking me and saying, I'm why she lost the election. No, InfoWars is because you took action. This isn't about credit either, by the way. That's kind of creepy credit. That's kind of scary to have that mob boss, that pedophile protector. That's what she admittedly is that monster. That criminal, that anti-American globalist hating you, just seething, oh, his dark heart. Oh, I don't know how he's going to be so horrible. Like Alex Jones and InfoWars. Oh, I mean, I'm like, wow, that is a Medusa. Hates me. But I don't have any fear. What you going to do, sweetie? You already tried a lot. So line up. But again, it's the spirit of liberty. I got to talk about the show that was under attack, and I got to set this record straight with people about where things really stand. But, that video you just saw or heard, the very powerful Mad Maxine, the Ultimate Maxine compilation is up on InfoWars.com and on Alex Jones on Twitter. Please spread it. It's powerful.
Alex Jones and the GCN
I don't think you need me to tell you that, though, dude. To your support, InfoWars has been able to expand its operations against the globalists at this critical time. And it's absolutely essential that we expand in the face of the enemy because, as history shows, political movements only expand or contract. And that's why the globalists are hitting us with everything they've got. Censorship, demonization, attacks, misrepresentations. They're not just trying to shut down InfoWars. They're trying to fire Sean Hannity. They're trying to cull talk radio. They're trying to silence true, independent, nationalistic media. And InfoWars is at the very heart of that resistance. We all see the dumbed-down trendies that appear to be soulless and how they're obsessed with consumerism and criticizing capitalism as they walk around in their expensive Nike tennis shoes and have their slave-made iPhones. So, I personally am disgusted by empty consumerism. But the globalists want to get rid of free markets because there is such a thing as positive consumerism historically, where people can use the power they have of the purse to actually support building free and independent economies. So you're not just getting amazing products when you go to InfoWarsStore.com. You're also supporting a broadcast that is the very front lines of the resistance against the globalist. Now, we offer a lot of specials at InfoWarsStore.com on nutraceuticals, on high-quality water filtration systems, you name it. But these particular specials that we're offering for Memorial Day and out into next week are undoubtedly some of the best we've ever offered. On the subject of colloidal silver, and of course with Knockout and Brain Force, these are the best deals ever. 65% off high-quality colloidal silver. Sign up for auto ship, an additional 10% off. That is 75% off. That's at least 15 points lower than we've ever gone to introduce folks to high-quality colloidal silver who perhaps have never gotten it before. We've got Brain Force, 47% off. Secret 12, 43%. Knockout Sleep Aid, 50%. Survival Shield, back in stock, 40% off. Super Male, sold out for months, 30% off. And you sign up for auto ship, cancel anytime, you get an additional 10% off on that as well at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. In closing, we've already come this far together, and we've seen the devastating effects truth has against the global crime syndicate, but the enemy's striking back. So again, for myself, the entire InfoWars crew, I want to salute and thank all of you. No matter what color you are or where you came from, if the love of liberty and justice beats in your heart, if the love of standing up against tyrants flows through your veins, we are all brothers and sisters together in this epic experiment that is life. So again, thank you all for your support. Visit InfoWarsStore.com today to get some of the best deals ever offered on incredible nutraceuticals, supplements, and so much more.
Take you live to the Central Texas Command Center.
In the heart
of the resistance. You're listening to Alex Jones.
For 22 years. What do they say? Christopher Walken? More cowbell. Booze and ladies, keep me right. To the show tonight, we're on American Band. We're an American band. I love it. The restoration of the Republic is here. John, Matt, John, Trent, Carlos, I'm going to you right now. Every time I put one of these out, the media does the same thing. They act like we're fake news because we're so on target and so accurate. We make mistakes, but we'll tell you. Media sources that are seen as friendly to the White House, not a lot of folks, but big talk radio gets this. And then we're good about getting it out within minutes of the White House releasing it or before it's even released. And then they'll send us hundreds of articles. Jones claims he has an exclusive White House press release. Well, we do release these first, but we're not sending exclusive. Then they just lie and say that we said exclusive because they're so angry we're getting these. Like, they didn't get press passes. Oh, okay, they did. Well, it's ongoing. It's just, it's like Trump. Every level, he's with the Russians. Every level, he's selling us out. Every level, he's bad as the economy explodes. Paris Accord. And these are the talking points. I mean, the headline is the White House has put out Paris Accord talking points. This is 25 minutes ahead of the president. Let's get Corsi on right now. I know you wanted to come on. I was about to go to calls. This is breaking, actually, because you're getting a first look right now when you get this up fast. A first look at President Trump's climate announcement, a really carbon tax announcement. So White House releases talking points ahead of Trump's announcement on the Paris Accord. I mean, this is huge. And we just Googled this minutes ago. No one else has this or has gotten out yet. The Paris Accord is a bad deal for Americans. You're going to hear the president say this. The Paris Accord is a bad deal for Americans. And the president's action today, this will be the press secretary, is keeping his campaign promise to put American workers first. The accord was negotiated poorly by the Obama administration and signed out of desperation. It front-loads costs American people to the detriment of our economy. Yeah, we have to pay first. And job growth while extracting meaningless commitments from the world's top global emitters, China and India. Exactly. I told Monckton, this is the angle to go with, that everybody else is exempt but us in Europe. And he goes on to say, China is exempt. The U.S. is already leading the world in energy production. It doesn't need a bad deal that will harm American workers. Yes. Undermines U.S. competitiveness and jobs, according to a study by the NERA consulting meeting that Obama administration requirements in the Paris Accord would cost U.S. economy $3 trillion over the next several decades, more than that. By 2040, our economy would lose 6.5 million industrial sector jobs, including 3.1 million manufacturing sector jobs. It would effectively decapitate our coal industry, which now supplies about one-third of our electrical power. It was half. The deal was negotiated badly and expires and extracts meaningless commitments from the world's top polluters. The Obama negotiated accord imposes unrealistic targets on U.S. for reducing our carbon emissions while giving countries like China a free pass for years to come. Bing bong, bing bing bong. Under the accord, just magic, world government blows up. Bing, bing, bong, 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 bing. Under the bing, bong, bong, bing, bing, bing. Got it, Alex. So we have, under the accord, it's just a little magic thing. Like I'm bewitched that he twinkled her nose, but just Trump goes, bing, bing, bong, bong. Under the accord, and all the tyranny's gone, see? China will actually increase emissions in 2030, but we can't. We have to cut. The U.S. is already a clean energy and oil and gas leader. We'll reduce our emissions and continue to produce American energy without the Paris Accord. America has already reduced its carbon dioxide emissions. Well, the scientists say we should increase it, actually. It's life-giving gas. Since 2006, CO2 emissions have declined by 12% and are expected to continue to decline. According to the Energy Information Administration, EIA, the U.S. is a leader in oil and gas production. This is all designed economic warfare to shut us down. That's admitted. The agreement funds a U.N. climate slush fund underwritten by American taxpayers. President Obama committed $3 billion to the Green Climate Fund, which is about 30% of the initial funding without authorization from Congress. With $20 trillion in debt, U.S. taxpayers should not be paying to subsidize other countries' energy needs. We should probably rename the name of our streams right now on Facebook, YouTube, and other platforms, because I know it was dealing with Trump, you know, prepares to pull out a world government, basically, and Bilderberg's now ensconced 20 miles from the president, openly trying to plot his overthrow. That's in their talking points. From not existing to now they admit they exist to admitting they want world government. So that's all happening. The deal also accomplishes little for the climate. According to researchers at MIT, if all member nations met their obligations, the impact of the climate would be negligible. The impact would be estimated to be likely to reduce global temperature by the rise of less than 0.2 degrees Celsius in 82 years from now, in 2100. Now, joining us just briefly, because I promise I'm going to John and Matt and John and Trent and Carlos here in just a moment, Dr. Corsi, our D.C. bureau head, again, got us first these talking points. These are all going out now as we speak. They're going up on InfoWars.com. If you want to see what the press secretary and the president are about to be saying here in the next hour. And you can also follow him on Twitter at Jerome Corsi, Jerome_Corsi. Follow me there at Real Alex Jones. It's more essential than ever you get his articles out because they're very scholarly. They're from insiders in the government that are fighting for America. And so, of course, he's been breaking a lot of big bombshells here. We haven't heard exactly what the president's going to do officially, but having these talking points, I think we can announce, we know, he's going to announce he is pulling out of it and that we're not going to be part of it. This is a big deal.
It's a very big deal, Alex, and I just got that 1 hour before the president's announcement. What the White House is doing is it's preparing those of us who are in the media favorable to the president to know what in advance is going to happen. And these points are very clear. It's very clear that the president is saying this is a bad deal and there's no compromise. We're out of it entirely. What the White House is expecting is that the loony left, as I say, is going to go insane. In fact, the talking points say to expect that there's going to be a huge revolt or, you know, massive outpouring of emotion from the left as we pull out of this Paris Climate Accord, but it's done. And we have.
And this is amazing because we're getting the talking points first. I know you sent them to me like 30 minutes ago. Wish I would have read my stack of news they were handing me. So this is big. We are now breaking that he will officially pull out because they weren't sure.
It's true. It's, we've got the talking points. There's no. They would never send these talking points.
And we don't want to have a baby with the EU and have a world government. I mean, it's smart to pull out of this.
Oh, it's. I think it's brilliant. I'm thrilled. I mean, this has been a terrible agreement from the beginning. It was punishing to the United States. It left the other countries of the world that were going to benefit. We're going to be subject to carbon restrictions. We have to cut back on coal, petroleum. It was going to be constant being part of the EU.
It's so discriminatory.
Oh, it was highly one-sided. Obama negotiated another treaty here with the Paris Accord. It was never passed by the Senate, never ratified by the Senate, but it was going to be detrimental to the U.S. economy. So Obama did something again that was going to punish the U.S. economy, and this Paris Peace Accord was that. And Trump realized it from the beginning. He let everybody argue, including Jared and Ivanka, both of whom were in favor of this, and Trump pulled out. He's going to do it. Rose Garden is going to be in an hour. We're getting the talking points in the White House right now. You see them. You've shown them to the audience. That just came into me with a White House address on it. I sent it in to you so you can verify it's got a White House address.
Well, that's amazing. I mean, you've got so many of these talking points ahead of the time. It even goes out to other folks in talk radio. But this is just now, again, breaking at InfoWars.com. Confirmed they had left it nebulous, but they had implied he was going to pull out. It is now official. When Roger Stone first said 3 weeks ago, the word is he will be pulling out. People call it fake news, but now we have the talking points from the press office first at InfoWars.com. It'll be going out on news everywhere as well here in the next few minutes, but good job, Doc, getting that first.
Well, I just want to give you the scoop, Alex. As soon as we got the talking points, as soon as
well, we're going to give you the headline. I'm sorry 45 minutes ago you were calling and I didn't get the message. You just start calling the bat phone whenever. It's nobody's fault in there. It's my fault. They were trying to hand me this stuff, but I was busy on other news. But this is a big deal. What do you make of Juncker, the literal royal Nazi heir, that just his family hijacked Luxembourg? He runs that. He's the EU dictator, unelected. He's threatening the United States with trade war. He's threatening England. And Soros says the European Union is now in existential crisis, surrounded by hostile powers, and calls the U.S. and the U.K. hostile powers teamed up with Russia. All because we don't want carbon taxes and want to run our own countries? That just means Russia wants to be sovereign. That doesn't make us Russian agents that we all hate Soros.
Well, in fact, what Soros is afraid of is this great dream he's had, which was, you know, within inches of being completed. Had Hillary Clinton been elected, you know, the EU had been flying along. And now what you've got with the EU is a potential breakup scenario. You know, you've got other countries within the EU are radically looking at their positions and saying, we don't need this. And, you know, Europe is in grave threat of being overwhelmed by Islamic refugees, and we're seeing the results of terrorism, and it just compounds the problem. Bilderberg is not going to be able to solve this problem, and Soros is going to go down with it. The pulling out of the Paris Accord today is a major, major announcement, a major step in the Trump presidency, as one that the Hillary Clinton presidency would never have done.
Well, I'm about to retweet your tweet. We've got an article going up on InfoWars.com with the press accord talkers. These are the talking points of the president. Again, ladies and gentlemen, he is going to completely pull out. This is going to only make the globalists come after him even more. A, B, does this not totally prove he's the real deal?
We shouldn't probably publish those talking points on the website. We should write an article around it, but I don't want to let the White House talking points get out any more than we've shown them.
Oh, I didn't know that. I wasn't clear,
right.
I was able to put the other ones out before.
It was okay. I mean, it's fine. It's just that I don't want to just put the memo up as such. I'd rather write an article about it and get it out once the announcement's made.
Okay, well, then pull it, because they're about to put it up. Guys, sorry, tell it, Don. It's my fault. Pull it right now if it's going.
Yeah, because we don't want to. I mean, the White House sends these out. We want to stay on the preferred list. We want to stay.
No, I didn't understand. So you're a great guy. Please tell me the rules.
I know. I got excited to see it myself and sent it right into you immediately. It didn't really...
Oh, well, next time, tell me the proviso that I need to not show the stuff.
Yeah, talking points are some that when we get them, it's the, you know, real trying to prepare the media for a blitz, which we expect from the left. And so this gives us a way to, you know, basically know what in fact is going
to
be.
This is the ammo to get ready to back the president. It's all totally true.
Precisely. And I mean, all these points, I think, are points that we're going to have to go through and debate. You'll see.
Well, they're well established.
Yeah, and these points are going to be reflected in White House press releases. So within an hour, what we have as talking points are going to get memorialized in White House press releases. The White House is going to be putting out these messages. And they're trying to get in advance the various supporters who are going to be on the media to be out there.
Well, listen, great job. John Rappaport's coming on the next hour. We're going to play the president's speech. But if you want to pop in later, that's great. I'm going to let you go so you can write that article, Doc. Thank you.
Okay, great. Thanks, Alan.
And tell folks again how they follow you on Twitter.
Yes, it's Jerome. It's either Doc Corsi or underscore Corsi, but at Jerome Corsi, you'll find it.
And I want to tell all the listeners, a lot of you send us whistleblower stuff, intel. A lot of times I don't feel like I can read secret documents or things. Not that I can as a journalist. I just, sometimes it takes me too long to authenticate and I don't get to it. Corsi has worked in classified areas and worked in a lot of things. And he's able to vet things. He's also worked as a fraud analyzer for the feds and has a degree in banking from Harvard. So you can always send him tips. And so give folks your email at InfoWars for whistleblowers and people.
Yeah, it's drc@infowars.com. drc@infowars.com.
Is that fully spelled out, doctors? Always just click on your email.
DOCTORC@infowars.com.
All right, so folks that want to get in contact with you or whistleblower, give you intel, they can do it right there. Thank you, Doc.
Absolutely.
All right, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, that's big breaking news. Sorry to the callers, have them holding for 40 minutes or 38 minutes. I'm going to go to you right now. We're going to go to, let me see, we got callers in Alabama, we got callers in North Carolina, we got callers in Tejas, we got calls from Oregon, Montreal, Canada. Who's going to hold the longest here? Let's talk to John in the great state of Alabama. You're on the air.
Hi, Alex, how are you doing?
Hey, good, thanks for calling.
Thank you for having me on. Anyway, I was wondering, would you like to be talking about the refugee crisis? Because I heard you mentioning it.
And they've been totally ignoring Trump, and the State Department is in total rebellion. We have record numbers of refugees brought in so far, 47,000 in the last 3 months. So total mutiny in the government against Trump. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah, that is crazy, you know, and I mean, yeah, the refugees in Western Europe especially, you know, you really have this surge of these, you know, completely Muslim and unlaw-abiding people.
Well, let's explain. They're coming from hell holes. Failed states, Somalia, Sudan, Libya. These are hell holes where women literally are sold on slave blocks and are not even human, okay? And it's like importing Klingons or something. I mean, you know, there are a lot of Muslim countries that are actually cultured. They're all being overrun and killed, and Obama and the liberals are supporting blowing up the good Muslims.
I agree. I know what you're talking, man. I mean, you got Libya. You know, Gaddafi's regime was a very secular regime, and you know,
Gaddafi never did anything. They blow stuff up and blame him. I'm not saying he was an angel, but he lived in a tent. He gave away 99% of the wealth of the people. He was the real deal, and he believed Obama was his friend. Met with him a bunch, invested his money in the West, let the CIA in, said I want to be your friend, and they killed him and brought in radical Muslims to murder everybody. I mean, how dirty is that?
Yeah, you know. I know, and they called Libya the gateway of Africa because Libya was really a state that really kept these
refugees. Yeah, once the globalists, and I'm not defending apartheid, they replaced one evil with an ANC communist evil, but now South Africa's imploding. It was jacking up Southern Africa and Central Africa, and Gaddafi was jacking up all of North and Central Africa. He was literally funding everything, creating an economy, and it's gone. It's all gone.
Yeah, I think Libya really has collapsed, and I don't think really it'll ever...
Well, she came, she saw, he died. You know how that is? It's so much fun to be liberal like Hillary. So much fun to be Bill Clinton, too, on that right plane with all the good buddies over there. Thank you, John. We're going to break. I'm going to go right to Matt, right to John, right to Trent, right to Carlos. I'm going to go into the next hour, and I'm going boom, boom, boom to your calls. And of course, then we're going to get into Trump's press conference and more. He's usually about 10 minutes late, so that's coming up in about 15 minutes. Infowars.com. Have you spread the link to the show yet? Because let me tell you, Hillary says we lost her the election by name. And you know what? We did. You did. But now the enemy's fighting back. And I'm here on the front lines. I'm going on to the end, whether we win, lose, or draw. But I need your prayers and support now more than ever. Go to InfoWarsStore.com. We've got products that are the very best at amazing prices, and it makes it all possible. InfoWarsStore.com.
Bilderberg 2017 is kicking off in Chantilly, Virginia this year. This is the first Bilderberg meeting since the populist uprisings of Brexit and the Trump election have come to pass, and the elites now see their power base crumbling before their very eyes. Among some of the subjects of the secret confab will be the Trump administration and can he be healed? Also, the rise of populism. Elites are beginning to fear that their power base may be crumbling. Now, three members of the current Trump administration are going to be attending: H.R. McMaster, Wilbur Ross, and Chris Liddell. Most Trump insiders believe that these three are there to help the elites derail the current administration. There are two ways in which this can go. Either the globalists will try to bring Trump to heel, or they will try to impeach him after the 2018 election. You can read more about this at exclusive Bilderberg Schemes to Overthrow Trump on Infowars.com. And ask yourself, what are you doing to wake up minds? Spread this link and help wake up some minds. Rob Dew reporting for Infowars.com and Infowars Nightly News.
It's Paul Joseph Watson, and the T-shirt has finally arrived. Nothing triggers Safe Space Snowflakes more than this slogan and my face. It is the new T-shirt from InfoWarsStore.com. Conservatism is the new counterculture. You've seen how much this triggers the Safe Space Snowflakes. The left controls culture. They control arts. They control entertainment. They have the complete monopoly on culture, which is why conservatism is the new counterculture. We are striking back in the culture war. This triggers snowflakes like nothing you've ever seen in your life. You've seen how much they absolutely hate the image of my face and that particular slogan. Conservatism is the new counterculture. This T-shirt is not only a conversation starter, it will trigger the holy hell out of leftists. It will make me incredibly happy. It's available right now. Get yours at InfoWarsStore.com.
The reason InfoWars Life has 5-star ratings on major third-party sites is because I want products I'm going to use for my family. I take this, my family takes this, and then it funds the operation with the most hardcore, truthful information you're going to find anywhere. So what you find in our news is the same thing you find in our products at InfoWarsLife.com.
If I ever forget to take them, like, I'm having noticeable difference. I don't feel good. The nascent iodine is one of the ones that was life-changing for me.
Yeah, I actually have just run out of my super female. I had a few bottles at my house, and I've been taking it again, hitting the gym once again. Very exciting, feeling great, looking good. So, and I know my hair is luxurious once again. So obviously super female is amazing. I love it.
Nascent iodine is essential. Survival Shield X2. If there's one product that I would say is life-changing, that I would suggest, it's Nascent Iodine Survival Shield X2. It's got a 5-star rating.
It's a win-win. InfoWarsLife.com.
This is the end, beautiful friend.
This is the end.
This is the end.
My only friend, the end, of our elaborate plans. Safety.
No safety, no surprise, the end.
I'll never
look into your eyes.
Again. Bye-bye, Brzezinski. Bye-bye, mass murderer.
Can you picture?
Bye-bye, David Rockefeller, Nazi collaborator.
So
death's the big equalizer.
Of some
stranger's hand
in a desperate land.
World government, its main engine, is about to be TNT'd. Donald Trump has loaded the explosives. He's about to strut out onto the green of the Rose Garden and detonate. Lost in a wilderness. Yeah. Not for long. Because you see, turnabout is always fair play. There's always an equal and opposite reaction in the universe. And we are in the Trumpian age, aren't we? No, I'll quote Julius Caesar, the play, again, by the great playwright, the greatest playwright ever, that there is a tide in the affairs of men when taken at the flood leads on to fortune. And our fortune's leader. Our fortune is freedom. Our fortune is expanding. Our fortune is honor. That's what we're looking for. There is a tide in the affairs of men when taken at the flood leads on to fortune. And fortune favors the bold, does it not? I could care less about money other than the fact that it's a weapon to build what I need to stand against the enemy's attacks. Like a lighthouse out on the promontory or a peninsula with big waves slamming into the rocks. I need money to build those rocks, not sand. William Shakespeare. There is a tide in the affairs of men which taken up the flood leads on to fortune. Omitted, all the voyage of the life is bound in the shallows and in the miseries. On such a full sea as we are now afloat, and we must take the current when it serves, or lose our ventures. Yes, most people live in the shallows. Most times in history, you're in the shallows, not times of change. You are now in the greatest flood of human change the world's ever seen, and it's only going to get more intense. So pray for us. Pray for yourself. Pray for justice. Pray for enlightenment. Pray for prosperity for all so we might be free. Not prosperity to have tokens of success or worship things mindlessly in consumerism, but have a house and a car and good health care and a life and a future so that we can transcend that and do greater things. They want to keep you frozen and scrabbling in debt so that you're always never able to reach for the stars. I'm going to go to break, and I promise I'm going to go to John in Texas, and then I'm going to go to Trenton and Carlos and everybody else. People say, oh, listen to these platitudes and all these big things, all these big words, but that's what it is. The mystery, the majesty of life, the consciousness, the universe, all of this, it's fantastical. And we're obsessed with Brad Pitt and how much skin cream he uses. I mean, Brad Pitt's incredibly boring. All of them, it's a joke. Who cares? None of it. NBA stars, NFL, crap. Arrogant narcissist idiots, most of them. But a woman and a child in her arms are just life. Just, yeah, all of it's magic. It's all just gifts from God. Hour number four and Trump's big speech as he drives a dagger to the heart of the New World Order. World government on its knees, straight ahead. Hour number four. Tell your friends and family.
Does your shampoo leave your scalp itchy and your hair dry and frizzy? Introducing Emrick's Essentials Natural Herbal Shampoo. Made with organic oils for an exhilarating fragrance. Enjoy all natural and chemical-free shampoo for a healthier you. Gentle enough for color-treated hair and sensitive scalps. Only pure, organic, antiseptic herbs that have demonstrated antimicrobial activity are used. Go natural. Go organic. No parabens or sulfates. Nothing to weigh you down. Get cleaner, healthier hair with Emrick's Essentials Tea Tree Shampoo.
Leading a frontal assault on the lies of the New World Order, it's Alex Jones.
They took my saddle in Houston, broke my leg in Santa Fe, lost my wife and a girlfriend somewhere along the way.
in defense of human liberty. Alex Jones.
You know, soon I'm going to launch a lot of new shows here on the radio and TV. And I'll probably work with GCN. I got to get around actually preparing the shows, getting the names ready, getting people hired. That's all happening right now in the next few months. Brad Port will be on every day if he wants to be, but definitely part of a roundtable show. So he does the show every 2 weeks. I won't be interrupting it with some news conference or something. But that's what we do here. We're really TV/radio. So as soon as Trump comes up, we're going to him. But I'm going to stay on as long as it takes to go at least 5-6 more calls and then holding patiently. And then Brad Port will pop in. NoMoreFakeNews.com. He had that site 15 years ago. You know, the trailblazer. That's who we have on. People, the trailblazers are people that are proven right by time. Time will always tell. Another adage that's an adage because it's true. It's a cliche because it's true. Let's go ahead and go to John in Texas. You're on the air. Thanks for holding. Hello, John. How you doing?
Hi, Alex.
Good. Go ahead.
You know, if Donald Trump is going to turn the economy around and make America great again, he's going to have to do something about inflation. Because if you might have noticed, the price of everything has doubled and tripled within the last, you know, 10 or 15 years. Look at the price of guns and ammunition. Look at the price of cars and housing. And
well, Trump knows that. Trump knows that. Here's the problem. There's such a mega debt. That's why it is. If we don't, we'll have stagflation, which they've cooked up with their Keynesian BS since the 70s. Where we're going to have less jobs, but prices still going up in a recession. So Trump's trying to help us blast our way out. I mean, look, the globalists are pissed. They want us poor. They want to strangle us. He's ordering the banks to loan. He's flooding cash. It's going to cause even more inflation. And Trump has decided to go the way of inflation. I mean, what else can he do? John?
It's going to defeat the whole purpose. If you got to take a wheelbarrow full of money to buy a loaf of bread, then
it's... Well, I mean, it's not going to go Weimar Republic or Zimbabwe. You're a smart guy, John. You've been calling for 18 years. Haven't heard from me in probably 6 months or a year. Okay, I recognize your voice. You're a smart guy. What does he do then?
The only thing I can think of is get rid of that $20 trillion debt. Put something in the gold backing of the dollar before they can't just print money.
No, I understand, but he's got to stabilize the economy first. So he's actually flooding money to the little guy. And I agree, that's got its own dangers. But if you're dying on the hospital bed, going into shock, he's injecting adrenaline. And it may kill us. But what does he do? I'm asking. I'm not mad at you. I agree with what you're saying, but he's taking the best course, I believe, for the patient he's got. I tell you what, I'm going to ask John Rappaport this question. We'll go to break and make more calls. John, you're a smart guy. What do you think? Well, I mean, on the economy.
Rock in a hard place. You've got to create jobs and you've got to, you know, pump up the economy. But I agree with the caller. Ultimately, what you're trying to do is get serious money backed by serious subsidies.
And that's how you kill the private interest manipulating things, is by getting back to real-based systems.
Yeah, but if you try to do it right away, immediately... And people are starving and out of work, and they're looking for jobs, and you don't bring enough jobs back here, then you're in.
Yeah, Trump's trying to give them respect. He understands we have to make a world based on humans again. That's why the globalists hate him. But even Ron Paul says we can't do this right away. Ron Paul says, quote, Trump's doing a great job on the economy. You never hear that of Ron Paul about anybody. He's saying great job on the economy. What do you think, Rappaport?
Rock in a hard place again, Alex. What are you going to do in the current situation after the giant theft manipulated by the globalists?
Tens of trillions stolen.
Destroy everything. Yeah, trillions and trillions of dollars.
And so what Trump's doing is he's just fire-hosing money at the economy and the people, finally. And it'll have its own problems, but at least he's fire-hosing it at us.
Yeah, the same thing with his plan to rebuild the infrastructure. If it could ever get by Congress or could be funded by some private money, we're talking about several $1 trillion to put people back to work. Well, that's not what you would call free market economy either. That's like an FDR New Deal. But it's a step along the way.
And by the way, if FDR wouldn't have done that, we'd have gone full communist. I'm not even a total fan of FDR in a lot of ways, but, you know, I mean, face it, FDR, what he did, probably some of that did help.
Yeah. Absolutely.
I hate to give FDR credit. It's just true, folks. John, I'm going to let you comment. We come back. We'll go to other callers. Trent, Carlos, Rod, and Matt. And Trump's coming up. We'll go to him as soon as he comes up. Big announcement on pulling out of the carbon taxes. We have private labeled it, and it is the exact same product, just the name is different. Emmerich's Essentials. It's on average 20% off. On top of that, if you sign up for AutoShip, you get an additional 25% off. Imrix Essentials is all about personal care, hygiene, not getting skin cancer, not getting bit by a bunch of bugs and mosquitoes. It's all there. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, and you'll find Imrix Essentials.
Every morning before I start writing or shooting a video, I take two capsules of Brain Force for a sustainable burst of energy. This is, without question, the most powerful nootropic I've ever taken, and it comes without any of the crashes or the jitters associated with energy drinks. It's additive-free, nothing artificial. It's Brain Force Plus. Read thousands of five-star independent reviews right now and get your Brain Force Plus at InfoWarsLife.com.
We've taken thousands of years of known research and put it together with our own 4 years of seeking and testing to find the very best systems that God gave us through Mother Nature to detoxify the body. That's why I'm introducing Z-Shield, toxic metal and chemical defense support. It's made in the USA. It's filled with known compounds from nature that are absolutely associated with detoxifying the body, and it supports the InfoWar. It is a classical 360 win. Our formula at InfoWarsLife.com is, quite frankly, simple. We go out and look at the recognized research, and we take it to the next level of quality, of purity, and of strength. Because this is what I personally use for myself and my family. We've gone through 5 or 6 different permutations in the last 4 years since we launched InfoWars Life to actually come up with this. This is the formula that I personally have been taking for over a year, and now we believe we have come as close to perfection when it comes to a detoxifier as you can possibly get. If you're not mitigating the pesticides, the heavy metals, the chemicals, if you're not trying to purify your water, if you're not trying to take products like Z-Shield that are full of known concentrated compounds that will purify our cells and our bodies, you're crazy. You owe it to yourself, you owe it to your family, and you owe it to the future of this country and the world that patriots stay as healthy and as clean and as focused as you can be, because we need you, the remnant of America, to reignite those brush fires to the next level and to be healthy and as focused as you can be. Because if you're sick, if you're over there on the sidelines and not in the fight, you're basically giving in to the New World Order. Thanks to your support and your prayers, together, we're changing the world. Now it's time to change our bodies with Z-Shield. InfoWarsLife.com.
The answer to 1984 is 1776. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
You know, I'm glad, as we wait for Trump to come out and give his speech any minute, with John Rappaport here riding shotgun with me, nomorefakenews.com, that John in Texas, I'm going to go back to so he can respond to what Rappaport was just saying and I was saying, what Ron Paul was saying here about a month ago. Trump has to first stabilize the economy. They've been giving none of the investment money to small businesses, small corporations, companies. They've been making us cash poor for 10 years. That's by design. That's admitted. Same thing in Europe. And so he's ordering the Federal Reserve and others, okay, we'll use this power of centralization, flood the public with money. That's creating exuberance. It's creating optimism. It's people are hiring more people. The stock market's up. And even I know the stock market's a big corrupt rig deal. But that's where the capital formation is for companies and jobs. They want austerity. The globalists want a sewn-up economy. Goldman Sachs wants a consolidated economy and high-frequency trading where they rig the market. They admit that. They want austerity. That's what carbon taxes are, is shutting the West off. Trump is removing all that, knowing he'll be a total rock star when the economy roars in. All he's doing is taking their foot off our neck. But we got to get oxygen first, and then, yes, we could look at some other systems. What do you make of that, John?
Yeah, I would certainly like to go back to, you know, the whole idea that Ron Paul's talking about. He's been talking about for God knows how long. Audit the Fed. Get down to the root of this whole money corruption and straighten it out. But if you're not going to do that, or you can't do that right away, while people are suffering, people are out of jobs, corporations leaving America to go to hell holes where they produce goods for pennies on the dollar and ship it back here. I mean, the situation is created to destroy the American economy.
That's right, and Trump is reversing that. Look at these jobs numbers. Private sector job growth rebounds to rip-roaring pace in May. ADP Nation's largest payroll service says private payrolls add 253,000K in May versus 185. Americans' comfort rises on strongest view of finances in decades. That's out of Bloomberg. Bloomberg now says Trump looks like he's probably going to win his next election. In the last 2 weeks, I've seen a total shift of people being sick of being force-fed that Trump's the devil. I'm going to ask you about that in a moment, Rappaport, but right now let's finish up. John in Texas, I confused you. I said, hey, John. Of course, it's John Rappaport, too. John, your final point.
Well, what you're basically saying, Alex, is when Donald Trump inherited this country, we basically he's a patient on life support. Now, he may be a brilliant surgeon. He'll do the right things, and he could pull us through. Or we could die on the operating table. It's just basically, I guess...
And he's basically like a surgeon and a couple nurses trying to fix it with 100 gremlins stabbing us while he tries to save us. Yes.
I support Donald Trump. I expect him being there 4 years, and... As long as Donald Trump supports the Second Amendment, I support Donald Trump no matter what. So,
well, he definitely is doing that, and I thank you. And, I mean, listen, I can't believe Trump's so real. And he's done some things I don't like. I could see from his worldview why he's doing it. But the globalists hate his guts. I'm going to go to other calls here and then let you take over. But as soon as Trump comes in, we'll get his first announcement, you know, obviously on the climate deal. But we have the talking points from the White House. He is pulling out of it completely. So that's big news breaking at InfoWars.com. But John... I mean, Rappaport, you're not a conservative. You're not a liberal. You've been an investigative journalist, best-selling author, art critic, artist. I mean, you've been around for 30 years making films, you name it. I've never seen you be so positive about a president. Why have you been so positive about Trump? You're a smart cookie.
Listen, the basic thing that attracted me to Trump and still does is that he's set out to destroy major media. You know, ever since I started working as a reporter in 1982... It was all about major media lying to the people and constructing false reality.
You've always made it about the fake news. You always understood that it's bring down the Oz curtain, and so Trump gets that.
Exactly. More than anybody, you know, in my lifetime in a position of power, for whatever reason, it doesn't matter. I don't care. It's not that I'm worshiping at his altar or anything like that.
My grandfather used to always say, I don't want talk, I want results, and Trump has delivered.
Over and over, I've said two things. One is he mercilessly attacks major media, and two, he kept Hillary Clinton from occupying the White House. Everything else is gravy. Let's see what happens. But this is, I mean, people don't even really sometimes get the monumental achievement of keeping Clintons out of the White House.
And then they bitch and say, oh, he met
idiot.
With us.
Yeah.
You know, he met with the Saudis. Yeah, to get them to do what we want. I mean, he said he met with Kim Jong-un. He took us out of TPP. They want to kill him. Bilderberg's own agenda is to remove him. They admit that. Is Trump coming in with a press conference? I just heard Trump. Was that a feat of something? It's no big deal. We're live newsroom. Let's do another call here. Let's go ahead and go to Matt in North Carolina. Thanks for holding on the air with John Rappaport at NoMoreFakeNews.com.
Hey, how's it going, Alex?
Good. Go ahead.
Listen, I've got a lot to say. I'm going to try to get in real quick. Basically, first of all, I just made a $400 order for InfoWars products. I'm looking forward to trying them out. Big fan of you, Paul Joseph Watson, Roger Stone.
Thank you.
I've tried to reach out to every one of you guys in regards to something that I think would help Trump supporters as far as the media trying to portray that we've left Trump. And I'm a visual effects composer, an animator, graphic designer, very skilled in all those areas. And I've also sent you guys a resume, which that's not what I call it. But I've reached out to a bunch of pro-Trump communities in Facebook, and put the idea out there of everyone coming together to show the media that we're still with Trump. However, a lot of people are proposing that we, centralize in one location, which in my opinion, I think that would be a very bad idea because most Trump supporters are workers. They don't have time to take off of work. They can't afford to do it. But what if you guys came up with a ledger, per se, and had people sign it in their areas, and you had local rally appointees to head them up in, everyone's local cities, and then, we could all centralize. 62 million people standing for Trump, the media couldn't ignore that.
Well, I mean, I totally agree with you and Cernovich. I think we need to all of us hit the streets more because all this Democrat, you're a racist, you're a communist, you're a Russian, is intimidation so we don't have our free will in our speech. We're Russians because we want lower taxes and prosperity. We're communists because we want... I mean, this is a load of horse manure. Thanks for the call. Great points. I don't want to talk about myself all day, but I'll tell you. I felt a disturbance in the force, to quote Darth Vader, and I don't really believe like that, but I mean, it's always accurate, so I'm going to follow it. I'm driving home last night about 6, and I really felt like I was in a fighting mode. Hillary's like a kingpin of evil. She's like a ringwraith. And I just like, man, they're really coming after me. I can really feel that serious stuff's going on, and I'm really hurting them. And I was like, please, God, I hope a bigger leader's come up so I don't have to be at the tip of the spear. I mean, I want to do it, but I also am a little bit selfish for my family. And these kind of thoughts I have in my head. And then Paul Watson calls. He goes, Hillary Clinton just said you defeated her. InfoWars is what stopped her in the election. Of course, it was Drudge and all of us together and everybody. But the fact that they single me out when she talks about me, she has such hate. And she is a murdering kingpin. This is Jeffrey Dahmer with an army. I mean, this is a woman that, you know, is literally supports whole combines of evil and exploitation of children. You name it. They've all been caught. Jerry Epstein, all of it. It is creepy. It's not a power trip, folks. It's not like walking some red carpet in Hollywood and people are waving at you because you're cool. I mean, that's sick enough. It's like to be in this position of where they are saying, we have discovered that InfoWars and Alex Jones is what advises the Russians. So now it's not the Russians tell us what to think, Rappaport. It's that they get it from us. You're InfoWars too, John. And then we command Russia. And then, I mean, this is getting insane.
Yeah. I spend all my days here. You know, you can see the hammers and sickles and everything around me and so on. Right. This is completely deranged. Out of control. It has been out of control for a long time. They keep up the same insanity. Yeah. We're feeding information to the Russians, right? They have one of the largest spy apparatuses in the world. The U.S. spies on Russia. Russia spies on the U.S. But it's you and me that are really feeding the information to Russia, without which they would have no idea what's going on, right? I mean, only a deranged person would even start to believe.
Well, have you heard Nigel Farage is now under criminal investigation?
Yes.
And of course, they told us 2 months ago, I'm under it. But then I never get called to these committees. Hey, FBI, come on over here, man. Let's go. Let's go. I'm not even saying the average FBI person is bad, but this is a load of horse crap. It's like saying I'm under investigation for being a Martian. You know, I'm getting tired of it, man.
Where's the congressional committee where you can go under oath and sit there and tell?
They have the committees, and they say I'm getting ordered around by the Russians, and then they don't call me. Since when does this type of
testify? Right?
No,
we don't want to hear what you have to say. That's the last thing we want, right? Meanwhile, I keep republishing this story over and over again. 20% of U.S. uranium goes to Putin. Bill Clinton, Hillary Clinton, Clinton Foundation.
30 plus mil.
You know, on top of that whole caper, imagine what would happen if it was Trump. I just republished the New York Times article that exposed all this 2 years ago.
And let me translate this. The Clintons gave the Russians more fissile material for their Topol supersonic Mach 4.7 missiles that we can't defeat. Russia doesn't have all the uranium we have. Russia is run out of fissile material. We gave Russia their next generation fissile material for hydrogen bombs.
Bill Clinton, Hillary Clinton. There's the article up on the screen for people that are watching. I think it was April of 2015.
Yeah, cash flowed to Clinton Foundation in a Russian uranium deal. Right. Imagine if Trump gave them 20-30% of our...
Exactly. This is what I was saying. The other day, I republished that Times article, and I substituted Trump's name everywhere that they said Clinton. And I said, what would be the reaction to that? Trump would be living in a bunker under the White House, you know, trembling in the dark. I mean, they would have him up for treason to be shot. And here's the deal again, how the Clintons sold out U.S. national interests to the Putin.
National Review, and I love how Trump's a real leader. Again, not kissing his butt, it's true. He tells the Russians, it is totally insane, Comey's nuts. Of course we're not colluding. And everybody's like groveling around. If you're not colluding, then say it's nuts. It's like, if they charged me with being a bank robber, if the cop showed up and said, you're a person of interest in a bank robbery, I'd laugh at him because I didn't rob any bank. I mean, it's the same thing. Okay, great. You know, I mean, Trump's like, oh yeah, the Russians, give me a break.
Yeah, exactly. And what about the Clintons? Let's have an investigation.
Well, the big news, I have this from high-level mainstream news since the 90s. You know this as investigative journalists, some of the top TV shows in the country, newspapers. But it was all over the news. They gave the missiles. They gave the delivery systems. They gave the MIRV technology. They gave the reentry devices. They gave the miniaturization warhead technology. They gave them lock, stock, barrel, all of our 1960s and 70s technology. They didn't give them 80s and 90s, but still, we could hit anywhere in the world in 1960, 1970. We gave them third generation Wernher von Braun Nazi intercontinental ballistic missile technology. The Russians wouldn't give the Chinese that. The Clintons did. So you can say something about the Russians. The Russians weren't dumb enough to give the Chinese their ICBM technology.
The Clintons did. For this much campaign cash.
Almost nothing.
That was the deal. There were prosecutions. There were trials. People refused to even think about it anymore. Oh, let's not cover that. It's not important. Not important that the Clintons gave 20% of U.S. uranium to Putin. Oh, who cares? Doesn't matter.
I mean, I'm going to be honest. I mean, what is the... If you give... the Chinese, until the 90s, could not get ICBMs off the pad. Most of them blew up like North Korea. It's not easy, okay? Okay, the Russians and the Germans figured out how to do it. So did the U.S. to a certain degree. But we couldn't do rockets until we got the Germans. Let's just face it. The Germans are the best, then the Russians. We heavy boost on Russian rockets today, okay, to show the slide in brain power we have. They destroyed the Saturn rocket codes for whatever reason. That's sabotage against us. We can't even make a Saturn rocket today. And then meanwhile, they gave this stuff to the Chinese. Why would the elite do that? John?
Well, we know the Clintons did it for cash. Why the elites would do that is because they want to provoke a sinking of the United States down to the lowest possible level because... Let's face it, it's really the only place on the planet that's left that has any idea of what freedom means and actually even has a vague concept of it. And that's what has to be destroyed in order for world management system of globalism to take over completely. This is the last bastion of any idea of what you, the individual, mean and what your freedom means and your power means. Everywhere else, it's fading into complete oblivion. And that is why the United States is the primary target.
And we're waiting for the president. I want to go to Trent. I want to go to Carlos. I want to go to Rob. And that's it. I'm going to turn the show over to Sean Rappaport, NoMoreFakeNews.com. But is this like you're caught in a riptide and you're trying to get some air as a surfer and you get pulled under? Are we just getting some air with Trump and Farage and some of the nationalist movements and Brazil's trying to struggle free? Or have we kind of gotten on a little island, you know, and crawled up on the beach? I mean, do you think we're just getting some air right now, struggling for our lives? Or is this kind of a new beachhead to a new beginning? Because I feel the momentum. I see it. But the globalists also are so crafty.
Right now, I would say we got some air. And it's up to us, really. Keep saying this over and over again. It's the movement of people who want freedom, determined to have it at any cost.
Your activity kicks our legs back up to get air collectively.
That's right. And if the people decide, well, we don't really want freedom, doesn't matter who's in the White House, doesn't matter who you support. It's the people who decided, okay, we're going to roll the dice on Trump because we hear what he has to say. We can't guarantee he's going to keep any promises. We know he could keep Hillary Clinton out of the White House. All right. But these people, these millions of people, still have their own idea of what freedom is, and that's the important thing.
And it's us exercising our will that is causing this global movement. So again, when Hillary says the info war beat her, you beat her. And I'm not patting you on the head. You need to realize the power you have, audience. I'm on my knees. My children, your children, we're in this together. I try to be an example of fearlessness because we're in a death battle. There's no point in being scared. It's all or nothing.
It's freedom or slavery. That's the deal.
That's right. Trent in Oregon. Trent, you're on the air. We're waiting for Trump's speech. Supposed to start. It was supposed to start 25 minutes ago, right? We'll see what happens. Trent in Oregon, you're on the air.
Yes, two quick comments, and hopefully you'll allow me to plug. I'm a 14-year info warrior, first-time caller. My first comment is on your video that you posted late last night, and I just wanted to say that you don't have to have any fear about not winning, not succeeding. You've woken so many of us up. We're doing the fight for you, you know.
Well, I appreciate that. I don't want to whine about it, and I'm happy because I asked for this, but every month now it's exponential, the attacks, and I'm fine with it. I just it's not fun, but go ahead.
Yeah, well, you know, a lot of us, you know, would... It's going to upset people to hear this, but a lot of us would take a bullet for you. So I
appreciate you, and I love you guys. I'm very humbled by the audience being so putting up with me because I'm pretty obnoxious sometimes, but I'm trying my best.
My second comment is a comment you made about 2 months ago on the show with Roger Stone, where you made it, you had said that some of the most good people out there with the biggest heart can be the most evil. And I'm here to say that really resonated with me, and that the only reason a lot of these New World Order folks are still walking in God's green earth is because we have restraint. And they should be thanking their lucky stars that we do have restraint.
Yeah, it's the good guys that are the real killing machines. And it's not a fun thing. It's just that, you know, evil likes to gloat, sit there and do all the rest of it. But really, the truth is usually evil wants somebody else to do the killing for them. God bless you. Anything else, Trent?
I'd just like to plug a great group of musicians, Small Leaks Sink Ships. Their whole platform is about waking people up to the love of God.
Say that again?
Crushing the satanic. Small Leaks Sink Ships.
Small Leaks Sink Ships.
Yep, their whole goal is to wake people up to the love of God against this satanic media that we're fighting every single day. God bless you, InfoWars, and thank you very much.
And look at all, thank you, sir. Look at all these globalists attacking Trump, the nationalist agenda, which isn't perfect but has a good will behind it. They're the loose lips trying to sink our ship, John.
They've been doing that for a very long time. I mean, look at what's happening now. Any conversation that would take place within Washington or the Trump Tower or whatever from anybody in the Trump team, it's obvious that it's going to be recorded and at the pleasure of any of the intelligence agencies that are working against this administration will be leaked to the press automatically. You've even got reporters who are diehard on the left that are not only seeing through this but screaming about it, saying, unbelievable that this is allowed to go on. Looks like we've got Trump here, right?
No, not yet. We're just waiting. We're just showing folks. Keep going.
Okay. You know, I've seen, it seems to me, Glenn Greenwald. He's one of the guys that's been writing about this. This is completely insane that anything is now leakable and major media don't care about
it. They can commit all these felonies, but anybody else did it or Trump did it, he'd be in trouble. And notice how it's old classical liberals like Greenwald and Assange and others and all these old CIA people that are liberals are actually the ones defending Trump going, this is a deep state coup. This is private interest just lying, running rampant. I mean, where is the old left? I mean, I would disagree with some of their stuff, but they used to be good people overall. What happened?
Yeah, listen, I used to know a lot of them, and they made a shift. I mean, you know, you guys actually, I think it was Watson who did this, just to show the level of intelligence has sunk to all-time low. That's what's happened to the left. But there was a woman who was interviewed, a young woman, about Brexit, you know, because all of a sudden the left and the young are saying, oh my God, if Brexit comes in, we're all doomed.
She said it's racist, it's evil, and she didn't know anything about it.
And then she said, and I won't be able to go to Paris. Remember that? She said, I won't, if Brexit comes in, she's British, I won't be able to go to Paris. What?
Total disconnect from reality. No, the EU bureaucrat, Juncker, won't be making all your decisions. That's all.
Yeah, exactly. The unelected.
You'll be able to go to Paris because they won't flood it with 10 million more Islamicists.
Right. Exactly. You saw, remember, when late 1990s, we had all these globalists protests in Seattle and Washington against globalism, giant corporations.
The left totally got it back then.
The left was there. That's it. Now, they're rioting on behalf of they don't know what, but what
they're rioting on the behalf of the very multinationals they were protesting in 1999.
Exactly. It's a total switch around. And the only way to explain it is they are so incredibly stupid and dumbed down now that they have no minds of their own left. They can only go along with, here's a slogan, eat it, repeat it, eat it, repeat it. That's all they've got. That's all they've got.
You know, that's crazy. They are literally funded by the very multinational globalists that are anti-free market crony capitalists that they were, the left was like good protesting WTO, taking away American sovereignty, exploiting workers. They were doing a great job. And now they look at us and call us Nazis because we don't want Obama's secret TPP that Hillary wrote. I mean, it's just like crazy. We'll be back with Rod and Carlos. Carlos, you're up next. The president's about to speak. He's 3 minutes late, though. The word is he's going to pull out. We're going to see what happens.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Bilderberg 2017 is kicking off in Chantilly, Virginia this year. This is the first Bilderberg meeting since the populist uprisings of Brexit and the Trump election have come to pass, and the elites now see their power base crumbling before their very eyes. Among some of the subjects of the secret confab will be the Trump administration and can he be healed? Also, the rise of populism. Elites are beginning to fear that their power base may be crumbling. Now, three members of the current Trump administration are going to be attending: H.R. McMaster, Wilbur Ross, and Chris Liddell. Most Trump insiders believe that these three are there to help the elites derail the current administration. There are two ways at which this can go. Either the globalists will try to bring Trump to heel, or they will try to impeach him after the 2018 election. You can read more about this at exclusive Bilderberg Schemes to Overthrow Trump on Infowars.com. And ask yourself, what are you doing to wake up minds? Spread this link and help wake up some minds. Rob Dew reporting for Infowars.com and Infowars Nightly News.
It's Paul Joseph Watson, and the T-shirt has finally arrived. Nothing triggers Safe Space Snowflakes more than this slogan and my face. It is the new T-shirt from InfowarsStore.com. Conservatism is the new counterculture. You've seen how much this triggers the Safe Space Snowflakes. The left controls culture. They control arts. They control entertainment. They have the complete monopoly on culture, which is why conservatism is the new counterculture. We are striking back in the culture war. This triggers snowflakes like nothing you've ever seen in your life. You've seen how much they absolutely hate the image of my face and that particular slogan. Conservatism is the new counterculture. This t-shirt is not only a conversation starter, it will trigger the holy hell out of leftists. It will make me incredibly happy. It's available right now. Get yours at InfowarsStore.com.
InfoWars has partnered with Defender Body Armor to bring you a new state-of-the-art line of advanced, highly tested body armor from InfoWarsStore.com. Defender Body Armor is certified to protect against all handgun rounds, even armor-piercing FN 5.7 pistol rounds. The secret to Defender Body Armor is its proprietary process and technology that disperses more kinetic energy at a rate higher than any other traditional body armor. Using one of the strongest synthetic materials ever created, called ultra-high molecular weight polyethylene, Defender Armor is also super compact and lightweight. There's a reason the Department of Defense chose Defender to manufacture their new line of advanced lightweight armor. It works. Defender Body Armor is made right here in America and has received the highest level ballistic resistance certification from an authorized NIJ ballistic laboratory. Defender Body Armor is now available through InfoWarsStore.com, so you can defend yourself, your family, and finance the info war against the globalists all at the same time. A total 360 win. All right, perfect timing. The president from WhiteHouse.gov is walking up live right now on pulling us out of the world government, $100 trillion per decade global carbon tax. Here is President Trump. This is devastating to the enemy. Ladies and gentlemen, this is unbelievable. This is a tax on what plants breathe, selectively by the globalists for total control. Vice President Pence just talked.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I would like to begin by addressing the terrorist attack in Manila. We're closely monitoring the situation, and I will continue to give updates if anything happens during this period of time, but it is really very sad as to what's going on throughout the world with terror. Our thoughts and our prayers are with all of those affected. Before we discuss the Paris Accord, I'd like to begin with an update on our tremendous, absolutely tremendous economic progress since Election Day on November 8th. The economy is starting to come back, and very, very rapidly. We've added $3.3 trillion in stock market value to our economy, and more than 1 million private sector jobs. I've just returned from a trip overseas where we concluded nearly $350 billion of military and economic development for the United States, creating hundreds of thousands of jobs. It was a very, very successful trip.
Totally delivering. Totally delivering.
Thank you.
I mean, he's delivering.
Thank you.
In fact, we have that British member of parliament.
In my meetings at the G7, we have taken historic steps to demand fair and reciprocal trade that gives Americans a level playing field against other nations. We're also working very hard for peace in the Middle East, and perhaps even peace between the Israelis and the Palestinians. Our attacks on terrorism are greatly stepped up, and you see that. You see it all over. From the previous administration, including getting many other countries to make major contributions to the fight against terror. Big, big contributions are being made by countries that weren't doing so much in the form of contribution. One by one, we are keeping the promises I made to American people during my campaign for president. Whether it's cutting job-killing regulations, appointing and confirming a tremendous Supreme Court justice, putting in place tough new ethics rules, achieving a record reduction in illegal immigration on our southern border, or bringing jobs, plants, and factories back into the United States at numbers which no one until this point thought even possible. And believe me, we've just begun. The fruits of our labor will be seen very shortly, even more so.
Wow, this is incredible.
On these issues and so many more, we're following through on our commitments, and I don't want anything to get in our way. I am fighting every day for the great people of this country.
He's under total attack.
Therefore, in order to fulfill my solemn duty to protect America and its citizens, the United States will withdraw from the Paris Climate Accord Thank you.
This is amazing, John.
Thank you.
Go ahead and finish, John. We can talk about this a little bit.
But begin negotiations to re-enter either the Paris Accord or in really entirely new transaction on terms that are fair to the United States, its businesses, its workers, its people,
I told Monson,
its taxpayers.
I said, it's all a fraud.
So we're getting out.
160 countries are exempt.
But we're not start to negotiate. And Trump, we will see if we can make a deal that's fair. And if we can, that's great. And if we can't, that's fine.
Yes, it's time to deindustrialize.
Bye. He's out. As president, I can put no other consideration before the well-being of American citizens.
Wow, this is so evil.
The Paris Climate Accord is simply the latest example of Washington entering into an agreement that disadvantages the United States.
This is heresy to the New World Order.
To the exclusive benefit of other countries. Leaving American workers, who I love, and taxpayers to absorb the cost in terms of lost jobs, lower wages, shuttered factories, and vastly diminished economic production.
The economic war on America is over.
Thus, as of today, the United States will cease all implementation of the non-binding Paris Accord.
That's right.
And the draconian financial and economic burdens the agreement imposes.
So Obama put us under this even though we didn't ratify.
This includes ending the implementation of the nationally determined contribution and, very importantly, the Green Climate Fund, which is costing the United States a vast fortune.
That pays for DiCaprio's planes to fly to the PR events and all the caviar.
Compliance with the terms of the Paris Accord and the onerous energy restrictions that is placed on the United States could cost America as much as 2.7 million lost jobs by 2025.
That's very conservative.
According to the National Economic Research Associates. This includes 440,000 fewer manufacturing jobs.
Talking points earlier somewhere.
Believe me, this is not what we need. Including automobile jobs and the further decimation of vital American industries on which countless communities rely. They rely for so much, and we would be giving them so little. According to the same study, by 2040, compliance with the commitments put into place by the previous administration would cut production for the following sectors. Paper, down 12%. Cement, down 23%.
Hell, there's taxes on beef.
Iron and steel, down 38%. Coal, and I happen to love the coal miners, down 86%.
Oh, it kills it.
Natural gas down 31%. The cost of the economy at this time would be close to $3 trillion in lost GDP and 6.5 million industrial jobs, while households would have $7,000 less income, and in many cases, much worse than that.
All paid to David Rockefeller's family. And
not only does this deal subject
these people are so arrogant
our citizens to harsh economic restrictions, it fails to live up to our environmental ideals. As someone who cares deeply about the environment, which I do,
it doesn't make China cut.
I cannot in good conscience support a deal that punishes the United States.
And not China.
Which is what it does. The world's leader in environmental protection,
it's almost like
while imposing no meaningful obligations on the world's leading polluters.
China.
For example, under the agreement, China will be able to increase these emissions by a staggering number of years, 13. They can do
2030, yeah.
For 13 years, not us.
See, he's not even reading the talking points. He's doing his own thing with them.
Contingent on receiving billions and billions and billions of dollars in foreign aid from developed countries. There are many other examples, but the bottom line is that the Paris Accord is very unfair at the highest level to the United States. Further, while the current agreement effectively blocks the development of clean coal in America, which it does, and the mines are starting to open up, we're having a big opening in 2 weeks. Pennsylvania, Ohio, West Virginia, so many places. A big opening of a brand new mine. It's unheard of. For many, many years, that hasn't happened. They asked me if I'd go. I'm going to try. China will be allowed to build hundreds of additional coal plants. So we can't build the plants.
But they can.
But they can, according to this agreement. India will be allowed to double its coal production.
His dad had nothing to start an empire.
Think of
they had to fight in
India
New York for it.
India can double white coal production.
Trump relishes
we're
this,
supposed to get
beating the
ours.
Big guys. He's a billionaire.
Even Europe is allowed to continue construction of coal plants. In short, the agreement doesn't eliminate coal jobs. It just transfers those jobs out of America and the United States and ships them to foreign countries.
God, it's like I wrote these talking points. This is awesome.
This agreement is less about the climate and more about other countries gaining a financial advantage over the United States.
They've sold us out. God, Trump gets the whole
story. The rest of the world applauded when we signed the Paris Agreement.
All you anti-American haters, it's over, dumbasses.
They were so happy.
Even if you kill Trump. Can we put the comedian
simple
up,
reason
cut his head off, show that monster?
That it put our country, the United States of America, which we all love.
They're American haters.
Very, very big economic disadvantage.
We're American lovers. See, it's not that we have the same talking points. We just believe the same thing. It's common sense.
Competitors and their wish to see us remain in the agreement is so that we continue to suffer this self-inflicted major economic wound.
Wow.
We would find it very hard to compete.
Ladies and gentlemen,
with other countries from
there's not just evil. You are looking at the return of America. Trump is real.
Among the most abundant energy reserves on the planet.
They're out to get him. I can't believe he's this good. This is so real.
Workers.
That every degenerate force on earth, Islam, radical Islam, the Pope, says it's an insult if you don't do this to me. That they hijack the Catholic Church.
Taking away the great wealth of our nation. It's great wealth. It's phenomenal wealth.
And if folks want to hear Trump by himself, that's fine.
Not
we
so
get
long
a lot of commentary
ago,
here on the
no
radio.
We had no idea we had such wealth. And leaving millions and millions of families trapped in poverty and joblessness.
Which they do on purpose. Wow.
The agreement is a massive redistribution of United States wealth to other countries.
Hey, Soros.
At 1% growth, renewable sources of energy can meet some of our domestic demand. But at 3 or 4% growth, which I expect, we need all forms of available American energy, or our country.
Yeah, they blew our energy sector. The coal's totally clean now.
We'll be at grave risk of brownouts and blackouts. Our businesses will come to a halt in many cases. And the American family will suffer the consequences in the form of lost jobs and a very diminished quality of life.
This is the rebirth of America.
Even if the Paris Agreement were implemented in full, with total compliance from all nations,
only half of the one, two,
it is estimated 0.2. It would only produce a 0.2 degree. Think of that.
0.2.
This much. Celsius reduction in global temperature by the year 2100.
It's all a hoax.
Tiny, tiny amount. In fact, 14 days of carbon emissions from China alone would wipe out the gains from America, and this is an incredible statistic, would totally wipe out the gains from America's expected reductions in the year 2030, after we have had to spend billions and billions of dollars, lost jobs, closed factories, and suffered much higher energy costs for our businesses and for our homes. As the Wall Street Journal wrote this morning, the reality is that withdrawing is in America's economic interest and won't matter much to the climate. The United States under the Trump administration will continue to be the cleanest and most environmentally friendly country on earth. We'll be the cleanest. We're going to have the cleanest air. We're going to have the cleanest water. We will be environmentally friendly. But we're not going to put our businesses out of work. And we're not going to lose our jobs. We're going to grow.
Yeah, China and everybody else can't have coal. We don't have it.
And I think you just read, it just came out minutes ago, the Small Business Report. Small businesses, as of just now, are booming.
That's right. Best numbers
since the
80s.
Hiring people. One of the best reports they've seen in many years. I'm willing to immediately work with Democratic leaders to either negotiate our way back into Paris under the terms that are fair to the United States and its workers, or to negotiate a new deal that protects our country and its taxpayers.
This is the new deal. Let me just say this while Rappaport's here. We'll go to the president. Obviously, we want to hear his full speeches on InfoWars without me talking over it.
So if the obstructionists want to get together with me, let's make them non-obstruct.
This is such history happening. We sold out America's industrial wealth, half the world's wealth, in the last 50 years to these globalist interests. They've been screwing us over on purpose, making us poor to control us, and Trump is destroying it. This is like World War II or something. This is as important as anything in our history. This is 1776 Part 2. What he's saying is so revolutionary, is so damaging to them, because none of the media would ever say it. It's just logic. It's just common sense that it's irrevocable. Like you said, that was the biggest thing in history to that point when I went on Piers Morgan and called him out as it was all fake. It was true. Not that I was great, just that nobody ever challenged him. With Trump, it's like that every day. I mean, is this not the curtain falling?
This is gigantic. The whole hoax coming down. The hoax on which was built the idea of destroying the American economy and other nations, and, which she hasn't mentioned yet, lowering the total of energy production all over the world, in all countries.
To reduce population.
Which would inevitably reduce population. That's what's behind all this stuff about reducing pollution. Yeah, sure, you're going to reduce pollution by reducing energy production. That was the whole model. It still is. And he's saying, bye-bye.
And let me throw this in. We'll go back to the president. We all want to sit here and go, oh, he's not perfect on this. He's not perfect. I have to be purist. But I feel like I'm lying to the audience if I don't just say I love Donald Trump and he's a hero. He's in so much. They're probably going to kill him. My gut says he's dead in 2 years. Maybe sooner. They're in camp outside D.C. openly saying they're going after him. They're coming after me hard. And I'm like 1/100th of what Trump's doing. They just kind of see me as like another archetype of the public. So they want to destroy me to scare people. It's not that I'm that important. Trump's important. Trump's real. There's no way he's not real. My gut always said he was real, and I didn't like my gut. This is irrevocable damage to the world government, okay, who are the worst people on earth. I mean, Trump, let's just say, Rappaport, with this and the TPP and the other stuff, he's done some other things that aren't perfect because, you know, he's got his weird kind of old-fashioned throwback right-wing New York stuff going, but, you know, kind of, you know, Roy Cohn stuff. But other than that, the point is he's real. He means what he's doing. He's pure of heart, even though we may disagree with him on some issues. I think Donald Trump may end up, if he's successful, he's George Washington 2.0.
I just say, look at the effects. Kill the TPP, and now kill this fake climate treaty in Paris.
That's even bigger.
Yeah, much bigger. Much bigger.
And then he explains how it's a total fraud. Hoax. He doesn't argue that the temperature data is fake. We all know that. He shows, why is all these communist countries exempt? Bull crap, man.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
I'm sorry. I'm ranting. Go ahead and go back to the president.
No. I agree with you. You know, he's saying, okay, we can't do this, but they can. We can't pollute here, but they can. You know, what does that mean?
And then they're running dirty smokestacks without scrubbers. Ours is totally clean. Water vapor, carbon dioxide that we need. They're running all this dirty crap. And then it's just crazy how the globalists are out to get us because they hate us. We're bitter clingers. Let's go back to the president.
And global activists that have long sought to gain wealth at our country's expense.
See? He's talking about the carbon tax. Wow.
They don't put America first.
Oh, my God.
I do. And I always will.
Wow. Juncker just came out and said he's going to defeat us. I mean, this is World War III.
The same nations asking us to stay in the agreement are the countries that have collectively cost America trillions of dollars through tough trade practices and, in many cases, lax contributions to our critical military alliance. You see what's happening?
I gotta put my hand on my heart because this is like
want to keep an open.
This is
mind.
Like the Star Spangled Banner.
At what point
about.
Does
this
America
is,
he get
totally
to
screwed.
Me?
Totally screwed. He's saying it all. It's irrevocable damage.
At what point do they start laughing at us as a country?
We want
fair treatment for its citizens, and we want fair treatment for our taxpayers.
He is really representing us, John.
We don't want other leaders and other countries laughing at us anymore. And they won't be.
I can't believe it.
I was elected to represent the citizens of Pittsburgh, not Paris.
This is unbelievable. God, this is incredible. This is going to hurt them so bad. Thank you, God.
I promised I would exit or renegotiate any deal which fails to serve America's interests. Many trade deals will soon be under renegotiation. Very rarely do we have a deal that works for this country, but they'll soon be under renegotiation. The process has begun from day one, but now we're down to business. Beyond the severe energy restrictions inflicted by the Paris Accord, it includes yet another scheme to redistribute wealth out of the United States through the so-called Green Climate Fund, nice name, which calls for developed countries to send $100 billion to developing countries.
Oh, yeah, it's worse
all on top of America's existing and massive foreign aid payments. So we're going to be paying billions and billions and billions of dollars, and we're already way ahead of anybody else. Many of the other countries have
global government
spent any.
I'm going to stop there because we got to end the broadcast. I promise I'll talk to Carlos in Montreal and just give final comments to John Rappaport. Please financially support us. I'm trying to build a network to block these people. We've already had such big success. Hillary says we lost for the election. You lost for the election. We have the Memorial Day special going through this weekend. I've extended it 65% off or 67 or whatever it is on much of the products. We never done specials like this. 65% off Colloidal Silver, 40% off Supermel, 47% off the Nootropic Brain Force, InfoWarsLife.com, 888-253-3139. I don't know how you couldn't try these products. They're so good. Everybody needs Colloidal Silver. X2 is one-of-a-kind product. We got the great, CNN terror stuff. I didn't get into Kathy Griffin with their air. But it's such a time to be alive. So I want to go to Carlos. Carlos in Montreal, Canada, you're our last caller. Thanks for rolling.
Thank you. June 1st, 2017, a very happy Thursday.
I can feel it. I can see it. This is a big day.
Yes. Alex, when on February Admiral suspended syndication for InfoWars, I applied a technique that I've developed over the years based on my analysis, what I call analysis of the tea leaves. And just to make a long story short, I thought of it's called semantic analysis of the main trends. And to make a long story short, I can call you another day and discuss it further, but I just want to let you know that we came with the idea of a sentence that describes exactly the trends. The Democratic Party lost the election, and they were effectively behaving, as the analysis shows, sore losers. Now, the term loser has come up in the last few days, which it just confirms our analysis. And so the message for a T-shirt that would carry to the election, the next election, would be better deplorable than sore loser. If you were to put that on a T-shirt, we did some analyses with 30 states that Trump won. The estimated number of T-shirts that would be bought from here to the election are between 600,000 and 800,000.
Well, that's exciting. I'll look into it. God bless you, Carlos. A great idea. But it's better to be deplorable than to be a slave. I think what you said is on target. I'm just telling you, I don't care if Trump isn't real. I'm not hitched to him. It's popular to attack him. But he's doing things that are devastating the anti-human projects, that are devastating to globalism, and that have them all wanting to kill him. And I just can't believe it's this good. Closing comments, John Rappaport.
This was an historic giant blow right here that we saw delivered. Gigantic blow against God knows how many billions of dollars of sheer propaganda about so-called climate.
Over 100 billion.
Gigantic money giveaways, job giveaways.
I mean, let's just say it. Trump is literally beyond. He's the real John Wayne. I mean, he's what John Wayne wishes he was. This was devastating.
Off the table. Just said, nope, we're not going to do that. Not going to do that.
He just blew up their whole program. John, thank you so much. Nightly News tonight, 7 o'clock. Oh, wow. NoMoreFakeNews.com, InfoWars.com. Please spread our links. We're under attack.